Recently, iQOO released the brand new iQOO Z7 for less than $300, but it's equipped with a 5,000 mAh dual cell battery and can support up to 120 watts fast charging. Today, let's do several tests to see the charging performance of the low-price mobile phone. It comes with a 120 watts GaN USB-C fast charger inside the box. Except for iQOO 11 Pro, almost all iQOO smartphones released recently have this charger inside their box. It adopts fixed input prongs and a single USB-C output port. Except for the 120 watts flash charge, the TrueLab Power Z KM002C shows it supports 65 watts PD protocol. The size of this charger is about 52 by 61 by 28.5 mm. The weight is about 126 grams. And the power density is about 1.3 watts cubic centimeter. The dual USB-C cable inside can support 6 amp current. Its length is about 1 meter. Next, let's take a look at its charging compatibility. Firstly, the real-time power is about 100 watts when charging with the original 120 watts charger. After switching to the 20 watts charger, the power is still close to 100 watts. We also charge it with the Vivo 80 watts USB-A charger, which can reach around 65 watts. We also replaced the original charger with a third-party cable. Since the current cannot exceed 3 amp, the power is limited to 21 watts. To reach the optimal speed, the original charger and cable are indispensable. As for the third-party chargers, we picked up nearly 50 chargers from 20 watts to 140 watts. TrueLab found almost all third-party chargers we tested can only support 9 volts, 13 watts. It's a little bit slow, but pretty stable. Same as the iQOO smartphones we previously tested. Then we'll use the original 120 watts charger to fully charge the iQOO Z7. In the first part, the voltage is maintained at 17 volts, and the peak power is about 76 watts at 1 minute and 35 seconds. At 60 minutes, the voltage drops to 5 volts and then back to 9 volts. The power also gradually decreases from 52 watts. It only takes about 28 minutes to be fully charged. It can reach 27% in 5 minutes, enough to deal with some emergencies. And it reaches 50% in 10 minutes, 84% in 20 minutes, and 28 minutes to be fully charged. While fully charging this phone, we also put it into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank to test its temperature. After 5 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 39.1 degrees Celsius and 42.8 degrees Celsius on the back. After 10 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 39.1 degrees Celsius and 42 degrees Celsius on the back. After 15 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 40.1 degrees Celsius and 43 degrees Celsius on the back. So the front is slightly cooler than the back, but the overall temperature is pretty stable during the test. For most people, a maximum temperature of 43 degrees Celsius is acceptable. Well, that's all charging tests for iQOO Z7. What do you think of its charging performance? The best charger for this phone is definitely the original 120 watts charger, and it'll drop to 13 watts when charging with third-party chargers. Although the charging speed is not the fastest, it's still very fast compared to Samsung and Apple, and the price is less than $300, making it more cost-effective. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye!